In 2001, Earl Granville and his twin brother Joe did something that would alter the course of their lives forever. They joined the Pennsylvania National Guard.
So my senior year of high school, my twin brother Joe was talking about joining the military, and I never thought I would want to go that route. Well, when I saw the National Guard would help with paying for my college education, I decided, you know, I'm going to serve my country. Joe and I, we landed in Fort Benning, Georgia in basic training, and being there for 11 days, 9/11 happened. And when those towers got hit, I realized this might be a little more than just the college education.
Earl's first deployment was Bosnia. Then, just 2 years later, Earl and Joe volunteered for a tour of duty in Iraq as part of Operation Iraqi Freedom.
The end of the summer of 2005, we lost our first casualty in the 109th Infantry. The month that followed, we lost six soldiers, also in the 109th Infantry, five of those in one day. I feel like, you know, a loss, obviously, is very heavy, but to lose five in one day that are all local here to northeastern Pennsylvania, it hits a huge toll, not just on us and our unit. You know, it hits real heavy with the community.
In 2008, Earl volunteered to be deployed to a major hotspot, Afghanistan, as part of Operation Enduring Freedom.
So at the end of 2007, we got a warning order for Afghanistan, and I decided I was gonna volunteer and go on that. Joe, on the other hand, he now has a family and his responsibility is to be here at home. What we did over there is we helped rebuild parts of the country that the Taliban was destroying. We were looking at a site to build a school. It was the first time in country that I actually saw bright green grass, and I got really excited over the headset. The next thing I remember, I saw nothing but black. And in my mind, I was saying to myself, what is going on right now? Why am I on the ground? Jeez, big beautiful skies, 2:30 in the afternoon. My feet are backwards and I'm full of blood. God, the vehicle is destroyed. We just hit an IED.
From that June 3rd explosion, Earl sustained serious injuries, including the loss of his left leg.
My recovery from these injuries was, I did most of it at Walter Reed Army Medical Center. And after a few days, my immediate family finally got the green light to come down. And Joe said to me, I should have just gone to Afghanistan with you. Joe, there's nothing you could have done, even if you were there or not. Hell, you could have been killed.
It would take multiple surgeries and months in the hospital before Earl was finally released.
I left Walter Reed and I came back to Scranton, Pennsylvania, not knowing exactly where to move forward yet, but I was feeling pretty optimistic. It was around Christmas time of 2010. I was getting ready and my phone rings and I let the phone go to voicemail. When I pick up the phone and listen to it, it was my mother. I called my mom back and she said my name so ever somber. And the words that came out of her mouth, I can still hear it today. And Joe committed suicide. I thought losing my leg was hard. But losing my twin brother just crushed me. Losing Joe just caused me to go in a little downward spiral for a little while. There was a moment, though, that helped me get back up. It was hearing from a lot of Joe's friends of how Joe used to brag and how he was proud of things that was accomplishing. And hearing that stuff kind of made me realize I can't be the person to let these adversities define who I am. I found myself physically challenging myself and doing activities that I would think in my mind would make my brother proud. And that led me to volunteering for organizations to help wounded and disabled veterans continue to live an active lifestyle. It helped me be involved in something bigger than myself that filled my life full of purpose.
Now Earl's ready to add to his unending story of serving his country and his community with a run for the United States Congress.
So I carry a cinder block with me on some of my races and endurance events that I do. And it's a cinder block with a chain around it, and we call her Cindy. And what Cindy represents is that all of us face some type of heavy burden that holds us down and stops us from enjoying life. And that's a metaphor that all of us in life, we carry burden, but we don't have to carry it by ourselves. When I lost my leg, the community here in northeastern Pennsylvania was so good to me. They helped me move forward, especially when Joe passed away. And I want to give that back. I am so grateful for this community. I'm humbled to be from this area. I'm humbled to grow up here, and I want to show my gratitude. And that's why I'm running for Congress.
Are you ready to answer the call to change Washington with a real patriot? Someone that will fight for our Pennsylvania values and shared beliefs.
I realize I can't do this alone. I need your help. The quicker we stop this divide in Washington, the quicker we can be unified and move forward.